So we're all set to go now with the first horse in our feature event of the afternoon, the Sport Ireland Classic. This is a 1.60 meter competition. It's a Table A against the clock. John Kyle, the voice of World Show Jumping, joins us. Who's the first one?
Well, yes, with this single round format, with faults and time being the deciding factor for the Sport Ireland Classic, and a time allowed of 84 seconds, we start with a rider who we saw on the podium of the Rolex Series Grand Prix at Rome Piazza di Siena earlier on this summer, riding Castres van der Bayernacker for Sweden, Petter Andersson.
So three fences on the ground, 12 faults, 12 total there for Petter Andersson for Sweden. So that sets the standard.
Yes, and the reference time, 78.96 as well. So comfortably inside the 84 seconds time allowed. Well, on we go now to a rider who rode on the Swiss team at the League of Nations debut show this year in Abu Dhabi. A returning visitor to us here in Dublin as well, riding Canis for Switzerland, Barbara Schnieper.
So two fences on the ground, 8 faults. That's the best score now, with after two horse and riders going Barbara Schneiper for Switzerland with Candies as we go to Tipperary.
We do indeed, to young Max Watchman, a member of the winning Aga Khan team 2 years ago and a member this year for the second year in a row of the young rider, the under 21 gold medal winning team at the European Championships. Partnering here for the Sport Ireland Classic with Quintini, Max Watchman, Ireland.
This one owned by Coolmore Show Jumping. Well, a good jump out over the final one. Four faults there for 72.96. That's into the lead now for Max Watchman with Quintini.
Well, Irish Olympian Commandant Jeff Curran is our next to go. Commandant Curran, who's been very well placed in a number of international puissances over the last 12 months or so, including across the water in Great Britain. He rides an Irish sport horse here, bred by Jerry Quinn, Hawthorn Hill, and Commandant Jeff Curran for Ireland.
Commandant Curran, based at McKee Barracks, which is just beside Aras and Uachtaráin in the Phoenix Park. Well, comes home with 17 faults, 8 jumping plus 9 times. 17 total there for Commandant Jeff Curran and Hawthorn Hill.
It's a shame with the interrupted time there, meaning that there are 6 further seconds added on to the total time taken for Jeff and Hawthorn Hill. We go on now to Irish Championship medalist and a career winner of the Rolex Grand Slam Grand Prix of Arkan and the Rolex Series Grand Prix of Rome, Piazza di Siena and Le Bourg, the Nationale de France in France. Dennis Lynch and Cordial.
Max Watchman leads at the moment with Quintini for Ireland. So out over the final fence there, but 3 fences on the ground. 3 for Dennis Lynch for Ireland with Cordial. Max Watchman's 4 faults is the best at the moment, but still plenty more to go in this Sport Ireland Classic.
Well, next we go to the very experienced Belgian competitor, Dominique Jouassin. Dominique, who's been twice a European Championship rider for Belgium and riding this horse, Bingo, that went very well in one of the top classes at Weyher on the Spanish Sunshine Tour. Bingo Z and Dominique Jouassin for Belgium.
The star of this one is Balou Drouet, and the star of that I'm Nabab Derev. Well, clear jumping, exceeding the time allowed. 2 time penalties there for Dominique. So that goes into the lead now. Max Watchman in second, and Barbara Schneiper for the Switzerland in third. So the course can be jumped. Just need to do it now inside that time allowed. Alan Wade has said a good, strong task for them here on the opening day of the Dublin Horse Show.
Absolutely. Feature class of day one and presented by Sport Ireland, as it has been for so many years. Another returning sponsor to us here at Dublin. We go back to another of those young talents, one of the top under 25 riders in the sport today. Bas Moerings for the Netherlands. Bas with a horse that jumped very well for him in Rotterdam this year. This is Jester.
So two fences down, eight faults, eight total there for Bas Moerings for the Netherlands. To remind you, tomorrow is Ladies' Day here at the Dublin Horse Show. And we'll have our best dress competition on the band lawn. All the action kicking off from 10:30 tomorrow morning. Please register in advance online via the Dublin Horse Show website to be with a chance to win a whopping €10,000 cash prize thanks to our very generous sponsor, 1664 Blanc. John, are you getting ready for that?
I've been excluded from it because I'm so well-dressed, as you well know, Brendan. We go on to U.S. Olympic medalist from the recent Paris Games, riding her Pan American Games medal-winning horse, Dorado 212. We welcome back to the main ring here at Dublin, USA's Laura Crite.
Well, the final one going there, plus exceeding the time allowed. Five total there for Laura Crout for United States of America with Dorado. Dominic Joosen in the lead for Belgium. Max Watchman in second. Laura Crout in third.
Well, now a rider who has been a big part of the US team challenge worldwide this year, from Abu Dhabi at the beginning of League of Nations to his home show at the World Equestrian Center in Ocala, Florida. Riding here, one of his Grand Prix winners from that Ocala venue, Gray's Inn. We welcome, for the USA, Aaron Vale.
So one down and four faults. Four for Aaron Vale for United States of America with Gray's in. That's into a third place. Belgium, Ireland, United States of America, top three at the moment. As we go to Italy now.
We do indeed, in the shape of Italian team rider and Nations Cup winner Giulia Martinenga Marche. Giulia here with the Scuderia Di Cinova Di Ciotto Calais Deluxe.
Well, brilliant round, clear all the way into the lead there for Italy. Giulia Martinenga Marco, that's our leader for Italy. Dominic Huyssen in second for Belgium. Max Watchman for Ireland in third.
Of course, Lorenzo De Luca also rode for the Italian Air Force sports team, a former winner of this competition. And that was the year he went on to also take the Grand Prix of Ireland on Sunday. So moving on, we stay with Italy, we stay with riders from the Italian Air Force sports team, we stay with riders who've been Italian national champion as well. Riding Gaspar, it's Giampiero Garofalo.
So two fences on the ground, eight faults, eight for the Italian rider, Giampiero Garofalo.
But it is Italy still leading in the shape of Giulia Martinenga Marche and Scuderia Di Cinova Di Ciotto Calais Deluxe in that time of 73.82.
Hold on, one sec, John. Can I ask you to go over that one again? Can you please call that horse's name out? In slow motion, please.
Well, in full, then, it would be a Scuderia 1918 Calais Deluxe.
Yeah, that does deserve a round.
Grazie mille, grazie, grazie.
As we go to Belgium now.
We do indeed. It is one of the top young riders. He's actually a member of the Young Riders Academy roster and had a very good five-star win this summer in Riesenbeck. Riding Clear Heart for Belgium, Thibaut Spitz.
And the final one going there as well. So eight total for Thibaut Spitz for Belgium. Italy lead, Belgium in second. Max Watchman is the best of the Irish so far in third place.
Well, going on now to one of the top-ranked Irish riders for several years now. He's been on the podium of the Grand Prix of Ireland and helped Ireland to Aga Khan victory in 2022 by just half a second in the jump-off. Riding a horse that gave him a Rolex Grand Prix victory in Spruce Meadows, Calgary, Canada this summer, Castorano, we welcome for Ireland, Conor Swale. Single rail down, 4-4, 72-98 for Conor and Castorano. That is going to go into fourth place at the moment. Just the one clear round, Julia Martinengo Marquet. In second on 2-4s, Dominique Joassin for Belgium and Max Watchman for Ireland is the best of the home side with the fastest 4-4 so far. But here's another man who could light it up, a championship rider for Ireland and a podium finisher in the Rolex Grand Slam Grand Prix of Geneva. Riding Django Santa Emel, it is County Lyth's Mark McCauley. Mark McCauley, unfortunately, also with the four faults. Django Santemel and Mark in 76-98 go into fifth position. So those run of three Irish riders, Max Watchman, Conor Swale, Mark McCauley, third, fourth and fifth, all on four faults. Well, another member now of the Young Riders Academy family. one of those young talents identified into that prestigious program. And she rides a horse that could be well-placed for this Sport Ireland Classic. Wins over big speed competition courses at the likes of Rome, Piazza di Siena, Shanghai, and the indoor London International at Excel. With Camosa, Van Het Kruiterhof. For Great Britain, Jodie Hall McAteer. Well, that's a shame. It is three down, 12 jumping fours for Jodie Hall McAteer and Camosa Van Het Kruiterhof. Well, this next partnership could be a very exciting one for the week ahead. It is a former Rolex Arkan Grand Prix winning horse, winning with Gerrit Nieberg. It's Ben 431, and in the hands now of incredibly talented young US Olympian Lucy Davis. Lucy Davis, Ben for the USA. Denied at the very last, 77.99 on the clock, and four faults for Lucy Davis and Ben 431. Well, next to go for the Netherlands, a horse and rider pair we saw in action in team jumping this year at Falsterbo in Sweden, and also on the team that placed second at Hickstead in Great Britain for the Netherlands. This is Gal Dalmi and Tanny Houston. Well, that Ardagh Charles fence raises its head again. It is 8 jumping, 2 time for Tani and Galdalmi as well. Total of 10. Just getting the poles replaced up there at number 8, and then shortly we'll be in a position to send off our next rider. German rider who rides out of Stefex stables in Belgium. Stefex, the hosts of the next leg of the Rolex series of Grand Prix at the Stefex Brussels Masters in just a fortnight's time. Kendra Clarissa Brinkop, great, great talent for Germany, and she comes forward now with In Time. Did so well in the Turkish Airlines Prize at Aachen last month. Top 5 there. Kendra Clarissa Brinkop and In Time give us a clear and go second in our Sport Ireland Classic on 75.40. Still the time to beat. Giulia Martinengo Marque for Italy, 73.82. But only 2 clears now. Well, Kendra Clarissa Brinkop earlier on top 5 in the Speed Classic. We welcome forward now the winner of our earlier class, the Minerva Stakes, Emily Conter of Belgium. Emily, in this competition, rides Trixie Z. Can't win them all, but happy to come out of this meter 60 track with just the one down. 4 fours for Emily Conter, and Trixie goes top 10 so far, 8th position on our leaderboard. A winner of a very big meter 55 class at the Rolex Salon Show in Geneva in December, and a Grand Prix winner in Doha, Qatar this spring as well. Henrik von Eckermann, the world number one, brings forward the Mare Glamour Girl. Clear, and 72.09 puts Glamour Girl and Henrik von Eckermann right to the top of affairs. The more than 2 years now as world number one, Henrik von Eckermann, the world champion, takes up the lead in our Sport Ireland Classic. On we go then to Irish Olympian Cian O'Connor, a four-time winner of the Aga Khan here at Dublin. He's a career winner of the Grand Prix of Ireland as well. And he teams here with a horse that went very well for him in the Grand Prix at Arkin this summer, the Rolex Grand Slam Grand Prix. This is Fermoy and Ireland's Cian O'Connor. He's done it. 1/4 of a second, but it is enough. Cian O'Connor and Fermoy into the lead, 71-83 for Ireland. So, follow that. Well, we couldn't have a better man even to give it a go. He's 3 times an Olympic gold medalist, and he comes forward now with Exit Remo, one of the top-ranked riders in the world today, Great Britain's Ben Mayer. Thank you, Ben. Ben indicates he retires on course there with Exit Remo for Great Britain. Arbigo, already a winner this season of the Rolex Series Grand Prix of Dinard in Brittany, one of the most successful French riders of all times. It is former European champion and Olympic gold medalist Kevin Stout. Kevin here with Beau Delobre. Eight fourths then for Kevin and Beau Delobre here in our Sport Ireland Classic. The time, 73.08, puts him in 13th of the ranking. Well, next to go, the 2013 winner of the Sport Ireland Classic. Indeed, Irish riders have taken 8 of the last 10 victories in this competition. It is Irish Rolex testimony Bertram Allen. Bertram with Caprisco.
Well, a great jump out over the final one there. Clear all the way, 78.45 into fifth place there for Bertram Allen. Caprisco. So Ireland's Keane O'Connor leads with Fermoy. The world number one, Henrik von Enkermann for Sweden in second. That's our top two. As we go to Daniel Coyle now for Ireland, he goes with Incredible. Daniel, 29 years old, from Derry, rides for Ariel Grange and the Lothian Farms in Ontario. Of course, was part of the Irish team at the Olympic Games in Paris last week. And what a tremendous performance he and Legacy put up there last week. So he goes up. Time to beat 71.83, but they must be clear. Well, a good try indeed. 73.17 into third place there for Daniel Coyle. And incredible. So Keane O'Connor leads Heinrich van Ackermann in second, Daniel Coyle in third. As we just over the halfway stage now, as we go to Belgium next.
We do indeed. A rider who is on the winning Nations Cup team, final team for Belgium in Barcelona in 2022, that was named Belgian Sports Team of the Year. Koen Verreeke, Koen with Casanova de la Pomme. The time to beat, 71.83.
So clear all the way there. Time 82.98 for Koen Verreeke for Belgium with Casanova de la Pomme. Into seventh place.
Another of our former winners of the class, it is Irish Olympian Dara Kenny. He took victory in the Sport Ireland Classic in 2018 and comes forward to challenge today that leading time of 71.83 with Sheik Sheik.
Look at the clock, 69.17. Into the lead now for Dara Kenny for Ireland with Sheik Sheik. That was a very good run. Dara Kenny leads, Keane O'Connor in second.
Keane O'Connor took up his lead by a quarter of a second. Dara Kenny is 10 times faster. 2.5 seconds between Dara and Keane O'Connor's time. We're going to go on to the Netherlands now. Older sister Sanne Thijssen is one of the fastest riders on the circuit. We welcome Mel Thijssen for the first time to Dublin. See what Mel can do now with the Grand Prix winner from Peilbergen earlier this summer, Grieg.
So three fences on the ground, 13 faults, plus exceeding the time allowed. So one time, 13 total there for Mel Tyson for the Netherlands with Grieg S.
Well, let's go on to a rider who's a familiar face here at Dublin, coming for many years. He was on the winning Aga Khan team back in 2008 as a very young man, and rides a horse that he rode here with us 12 months ago as well in the main arena of Dublin. This is Guest List and Great Britain's Tim Gredley.
This one by Cicero. And the sire of the dam, Plotir, owned by the Unex Competition Yard in Newmarket. So a good run there, clear all the way, clear 80.73 for Tim Gredley for Great Britain with Guest List, ranked eighth now. But Dara Kenny leads, Keane O'Connor in second, Hedrick Van Ackerman in third.
So let's go on to our Australian visitor already in the prizes earlier on in the Minerva Stakes. Welcome back to the main ring, Isabella Stone. Isabella on this occasion rides one of the Oaks bred horses from Australia, Oaks Ventriloquist.
So it faults, it there for Isabella Stone for Australia.
Rolling along in our start list then for this Sport Ireland Classic this afternoon, we welcome forward a World Team Bronze medalist for Great Britain and the number four for Great Britain at the recent Paris Olympic Games as well. Riding his Nations Cup horse from two legs of the series in the United Arab Emirates this spring, E-Banking. It is Great Britain's Joe Stockdale.
Good round from Joe Stockdale. He banking a 74.95 into sixth place. Dara Kenny still leads for Ireland. Keane O'Connor in second. Andrew van Eckerman for Sweden in third. Daniel Coyle for Ireland in fourth. They're the top four at the moment.
Well, the winner this summer of the Rolex Grand Prix at Royal Windsor, one of three five-star victories he's had over the course of the 2024 season. We welcome forward now Rolex testimony, Martin Fuchs. Martin, Swiss Olympian, rides Bastille.
Well, a clear all the way. Slow time, 78.27 there for Martin Fuchs for Switzerland, with Bastille into eighth place.
Well, next to go, it is for the Netherlands, a three-time Dutch Olympian and championship medalist, former world number one as well, Harry Smulders. Harry here with his Valkenswaard Grand Prix winner from this summer, Mr. Tack.
Mr. Tack is by a non-stop. Sorry that I'm too long. So the one fence on four faults, four there for Harry Smulders for the Netherlands with Mr. Tack. Dara Kenny still leads the Sport Ireland Classic with Chic Chic. Keane O'Connor in second with Fermoy. And third place for Sweden, Hendrik van Eckerman, the world number one with the brilliant Glamour Girl.
Well, another rider from County Derry based over in Great Britain now in West Sussex near Hickstead, where he was the winner last year with this then 8-year-old horse of the prestigious Hickstead Derby. Piotr van der Kroeshover and Ireland's David Simpson next to go in our Sport Ireland Classic.
This is Stallion by Bemucca de Moose. And the start of the dam is Taran de la Pomme. Well, a good shot to the final one there. Clear all the way for David Simpson, 77.55 into eighth place. You really need to be moving around this track, set by our course designer, Alan Wade.
Yeah, but then you look at Dara Kenny's leading margin as well with Chic Chic of 2.5 seconds over nearest competitor, Kian O'Connor and Fomoy. Really is going to take quite a bit of chasing. Well, this horse and rider pair were in action this summer in the Rolex Summer Series at Spruce Meadows in Calgary, Canada. It is team and individual European medalist for Belgium, Jos Valoy. Jos rides Origine.
Well, a nice run there, clear all the way, 80.18 for Jos Verlaye for Belgium with Origine. Still well off the pace, but a good clear round for him to get him underway here at the Dublin Horse Show this week.
Well, double winner in recent years for Ireland was Paul O'Shea, and we welcome forward now last year's winner, hoping he can follow in Paul's footsteps and become a double winner of the Sport Ireland Classic. We welcome forward two-time Olympian for Ireland, Shane Sweetnam. Shane with Irondole du Flot.
Irondole du Flot is a mare by Vivaldi du Signor and the Saradam Ogano seat. Well, eight faults, eight there for Shane Sweetnam with Ronald Duflo. Still no change at the top of the leaderboard at the moment. Ireland 1-2, Sweden in third, Ireland fourth, Italy in fifth, and Great Britain in sixth. There are top six at the moment in this Sport Ireland Classic.
We'll see if it changes here in a moment. Another rider who has picked up several Rolex Grand Slam Grand Prix wins, including the prestigious Grand Prix of Aachen. He rides Bingo Sont ML for our Sport Ireland Classic. We welcome for Germany, Daniel Deusser.
Well, a flyer at the last there. Good round. Clear all the way for Daniel Deusser for Germany. 74-23 into six now. That pushes Joe Stockdale down into seventh.
We go on to Sweden for our next contender, taking on that leading time of 69-17. We welcome forward riding her Nations Cup horse from Hickstead, Kavici. It is Erika Swartz-Ryan, Sweden.
Well, clear all the way there. Clear 82-91 for Erika Swartz Ryan. Kavici Z for Sweden. Coming towards the final third of the class.
And to take a step, we get the tone now for Steve Goddard, the individual Olympic medalist, the silver medalist from Paris. Steve Goddard riding a horse that went very well for him in the Derby Tour at Dinard and also at Falsterbo in recent seasons. Could we see him go well in the Speed Derby here this week in Dublin? Steve Goddard and Easy Star de Talma.
Well, a brilliant run there. Clear all the way, 74-71 for Steve Goddard for Switzerland with Easy Star the Tame into seventh place. A 11 left to go now in this Sport Ireland Classic. Dara Kenny for Ireland leads. Keane O'Connor for Ireland in second. And the world number one, Hendrik van Enkerman for Sweden in third.
Go on now to a rider who is part of the Irish team that for the first time in over 90 years lifted aloft the Nations Cup at Rome Piazza di Siena last summer. It is Mikey Pender, Mikey for Ireland with the Irish bred HHS Los Angeles. Los Angeles owned by Bravo Hughes, bred by Marion Hughes, by Loire out of a Cavalier Royal mare.
Wow, what a shot at the final one. 70.20, not quite fast enough. Into second place there for Mikey Pender with HHS Los Angeles. Give another big round of applause, Mikey Pender. That was a good round. Faster the next time, Mikey.
Does give us an Irish 1-2-3 at the moment and just goes back to exactly how fast Dara Kenny and Sheik Sheik were. And nobody yet to touch them, not even Mikey Pender with that great daring round with Los Angeles. On we go then to a rider we saw in great shape in the earlier Minerva Stakes class. Coming out with his top horse, Value de Lys, we welcome back from France, Julien Gonin. Right, you're getting very tired in the afternoon sun, ladies and gentlemen. From France, Julien Gonin.
That was a bit aggressive. Well, just the one fence on, four faults, four there for Julien going in for France.
Well, now our Grand Prix winner of 2 years ago here at Dublin, Édouard Schmitz for Switzerland, teaming up with a horse that gave him a world ranking class win this spring in Spain on the Sunshine Tour. Abdeljabbar de Gibe and Édouard Schmitz, Switzerland.
So just the one fence down there, four faults, four for Édouard Schmitz for Switzerland. Dara Kenny leads, Mikey Pender in second, Keane O'Connor in third in this Sport Ireland Classic. So some very fast ones still to go, including our opening winner for the afternoon, Fran O'Derwin. Niamh McAvoy is in there, Yannicka Sprunga for Switzerland. And the last to go will be McLean Ward for United States. But next up,
it is for the USA, a returning rider to us here at the Dublin Horse Show. He rides an Irish bred by Pacino, out of a mare by Cavalier Royal and owned by new owners for him, Ashland Farms. It's HHS Seattle. It's a man who studied geology at university, and he's going to have to dig deep to beat Dara Kenny 69.17. We welcome Spencer Smith.
So a good run there for Spencer Smith with the Irish bred HHS Seattle. 74.06 into seventh place for Spencer. That'll keep Jimmy Doyle happy on day one.
We go back to Tipperary now in the shape of Tom Watchman. Tom, who has also been a youth championship medalist for Ireland and riding at the very top level under the mentorship of Kian O'Connor. Riding Coolmore Show Jumping's Catalina S, Tom Watchman for Ireland.
Well, give it a good try. Unfortunately, two fences on the ground, eight faults. Eight in a time of 72.15 there for Tom Watchman and Catalina S.
Tom and Catalina together are on the Young Rider Team gold medal winning team this summer in the Netherlands as well. We'll be celebrating those youth championship team performances later on this week in the main arena here at Dublin. As we go back to France for our next contender, Marie Pellegrin. Marie here with D'Acoustiques de Aiglefin. Four more at the last for a total of eight for Marie Pellegrin and D'Acoustiques de Aiglefin. Team horse for several times over this summer, including recently at Hickstead on the French Nations Cup team. We'll carry on towards the end of this Sport Ireland Classic now with our first international winner of the day, Francis Derwin Jr., graduate, of course, of the ponies here in the main arena. In the mix several times over in the 14-2 final that runs away after the Aga Khan here on Friday. Riding the Irish Sport Horse by Flexibil, Flexi-K, Francis Derwin, Ireland.
So eight faults there, eight for Franco Derwin and Flexi K. But he certainly had a good start to the Dublin Horse Show. As John mentioned, a big winner of her opening speed. As we come to the final four in this Sport Ireland Classic, it's a 1-2-3 for Ireland. Will it stay like that? Well, the last of the Irish riders to go now.
Yeah, and we're going to take another one of our youth medalists from the Netherlands this summer. Youth young rider, Team Gold, Niamh McAvoy. Niamh here with Jasmine de Hermida. We've already seen Niamh in podium form earlier on in the speed stakes. In fact, second to Franco Derwin. A jumping 10 for time for Niamh and Jasmine de Hermida here in our Sport Ireland Classic. So three more to see. That was the last Irish challenger. Ireland still holding the top three spots. Darragh Kenny, Mikey Pender, Kian O'Connor in those best three spots. The world number one, Henrik Conor Eckermann in fourth. Daniel Coyle, Irish Olympic finalist in fifth. A rider who we saw in the placings of that same speed stakes class earlier on today. We welcome her back to the main ring. Another of our under 25 stars of the sport. She was third in the 1.5 million euro Global Champions Grand Prix of Monaco this year. Riding Dynasty de Beaufort for the Reign family of Canada. This is France's Nina Malvay.
Well, clear all the way there, 83-24. Nina Malvay for France. So the leaderboard. Don, it's looking good at the moment for another win for Ireland. Dara Kenny leads with Sheik Sheik. Mikey Pender in second with Hitch Hitch S Los Angeles. And Keane O'Connor with Fermoy in third.
Just behind those three is Henrik von Eckermann, an Olympic gold medalist, world champion and world number one of the sport. And amongst his many other accolades, he is also Mr. Jannike Sprunger. Jannike here now with Aurelie, her World Cup podium finishing horse from Basel. Swiss Olympian Jannike Sprunger on course.
Well, just the one fence on, four faults for Jannike Sprunger for Switzerland with the relay. So we come to our final competitor, the only one that'll be able to deny a win for Dara Kenny, and he's certainly a dangerous one against the clock.
Absolutely. He has in his career won so many of the big Grand Prix around the world, the likes of Geneva, also the... Grand Prix here of Dublin in Ireland, the Grand Prix of Rome at Piazza di Siena. To bring it home, trying to take on 69.17 is a twice Olympic gold medalist for the USA, riding First Lady McLean Ward.
Well, a good try, McLean. 70.96, good enough for third position. And that pushes Keane O'Connor down into fourth. But we can confirm the second winner of the afternoon for the home side. It's a win for Dara Kenny of the Sports Ireland Classic. Dara Kenny wins with Cheek Cheek, 69.17. In second, Mikey Pender, 70.20 with HHS Los Angeles. McLean Ward for United States of America taking third with First Lady Clear, 70.96. In fourth place, Keane O'Connor with Fermoy Clear, 71.83. In fifth place, Henrik von Eckermann for Sweden Clear, 72.09. And in sixth place, Daniel Coyle for Ireland with Incredible Clear, 73.17. Please do stay with us for the presentation. John Kyle will take us through the presentation.
as a day of returning sponsors here as well. We'd like to thank so much Sport Ireland. Sport Ireland, the authority tasked with the development of sport here in Ireland, including participation in sport, high-performance sport, anti-doping, coaching, and the development of the Sport Ireland campus at Abbottstown. The National Sports Policy set out in 2018 sets out the context in which Sport Ireland are going to operate over the next 10-year cycle. Sport Ireland strongly endorsing the sports policy and, as the statutory agency responsible, will have the lead role in many of the key operational and strategic challenges contained within that policy. Sport Ireland are huge supporters of the Olympic ambitions of Horse Sport Ireland, the national governing body for equestrian sport, and of course, huge support to the whole of Team Ireland at the recent Paris Olympic Games. After this award ceremony, we'll be turning our attention to some of the best of national show jumping, including some of our stars of the future, as we welcome forward the Young Riders competition sponsored by Fairshare ESG here. And they will be starting jumping at 6:15 for their jump-off class. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome them in, the prize winners of the Sport Ireland Classic with us here on day one of the 2024 RDS Dublin Horse Show. In eighth place for the USA, Spencer Smith. In seventh place for Italy, Giulia Martinengo Marche. In sixth place for Ireland, Daniel Coyle. In fifth for Sweden, Henrik von Eckermann. In fourth for Ireland, Kian O'Connor. In third for the United States of America, McLean Ward. Our runner-up for Ireland, Mikey Pender, and your winner, riding Chic Chic in an unbeatable 69-17, Dara Kenny. Well, Gillian Kyle, member of the Equestrian Committee, will be representing Sport Ireland here today for the award ceremony, accompanied by John Dardis, president of the Royal Dublin Society, and on behalf of our International Equestrian Federation officials, Dervla Campbell-Grieve, member of the Grand Jury, will be adding her congratulations to each of our prize-winning athletes here in the Sport Ireland Classic. Well, with our lineup nearly complete and our winner in the winner's circle. We will honour our victory in this international competition in the traditional fashion. Ladies and gentlemen, could I ask you please, if you can, to rise for the national anthem of Ireland, Aron Nevean. Well done, Dara. Dara and Sheik Sheik taking victory in this competition. Our Irish Olympian from the Tokyo Games, the number four behind the team in Paris at Versailles over the course of the last fortnight as well. Dara and Sheik Sheik were just unbeatable. They took a 2.5 second lead at the time. A clear blue water that was filled in by Mikey Pender and at last to go McLean Ward, but nobody could quite touch Dara for the victory. So Gillian Kyle of the Equestrian Committee here at the Royal Dublin Society, representing Sport Ireland, accompanied by John Dardis, president of the RDS, congratulating Dara on his victory. First victory of the week for County Offaly as well. And indeed, Dara, a former winner of the prestigious Royal Dublin Society Bursary, which is a competition run for the leading young riders of the show. It is the young riders who come up next. And indeed, our second place finisher is also a career winner of that bursary. Hailing from County Kildare, but very much now involved with the Hughes Horse Stud operation in Coffs Grange, County Kilkenny, riding HHS Los Angeles, our runner-up, Ireland's Mikey Pender. Well, a two-time Olympic gold medalist, two-time Olympic team silver medalist as well, and career winner of the Grand Prix here at Dublin. Our third place finisher, First Lady, ridden by McLean Ward, the USA. Our presentation party move on now to our fourth place finisher. Again, a Grand Prix winner here, a four-time Aga Khan winning team member as well, riding for Moy, Ireland and Dublin's Kian O'Connor. Rounding out the top five then, it's fantastic to have this man here, the reigning world number one, the world champion, the twice World Cup champion with Glamour Girl, Henrik von Eckermann, Sweden. Oh, what a run this man, next man had through the Paris Games as well, jumping three impeccable clear rounds to make the individual final of the Paris Games, riding incredible to sixth in this class, Derry's Daniel Coyle. Our presentation party now with our Italian visitor, one of two individuals for Italy this year, with Scuderia 19-18 Cali Deluxe, Giulia Martinengo Marche. And then another Hughes-bred horse. It is HHS Seattle, the Irish sport horse for the USA's Spencer Smith that rounds out our top eight. Well, thanks to Gillian Kyle on behalf of Sport Ireland, John Dardis, RDS President, and Dervla Campbell-Grieve on behalf of our judges and International Equestrian Federation officials here this week, congratulating our prize winners of the Sport Ireland Classic. Well, he definitely knows the way because he was victorious in this class in 2018. Let's ask Dara Kenny to lead away our lap of honor here, winning in 2024 with Chic Chic. Well done, the Anglesey stand. Dara Kenny passes us. Let's hear it for Mikey Pender. And always a welcome visitor here, McLean Ward. Kian O'Connor placed fourth. Henrik von Eckermann, Daniel Coyle passes us here at the jury box. So does Primo Avieri, Julia Martinenga Marquet. And for the USA, Spencer Smith. Are we ready over here to send the man from Offaly away? Unbeatable against the clock, ladies and gentlemen, Dara Kenny!